What will we do with this moment? How will we be remembered? This is our future and our choice to make. I am asking you to choose greatness.
Welcome back to Real Trump News. Real news President Trump doesn't want you to miss. First, the White House writes, in historic moment, President Trump was joined this week by Vice Premier of China in the White House. Together, they signed a new fully enforceable trade agreement that rebalances this vital trade partnership while boosting American business, farmers, and manufacturers and innovators. From day one, my administration has fought tirelessly to achieve a level playing field for the American worker, President Trump said. Before he took office, Washington had long tolerated unfair trade practices that fuel special interests while hurting U.S. working and middle-class families. The new agreement makes good on a number of key promises to fix trade with China. First, for American-made products, to help rebalance the relationship, China has pledged to increase imports of American goods and services by at least $200 billion. Second, for agricultural purchases, as part of that commitment, China will be stocking up on goods from U.S. farmers between $40 and $50 billion worth. Third, no more forced technology transfer. For the first time ever, China agreed to end its practice of forcing American companies to transfer their technology to Chinese companies as a condition for doing business there. Fourth, for fair currency practices, Beijing has agreed to stronger commitments on its practices regarding currency devaluation and exchange rates. And that's just phase one. The work on phase two deal is already underway. President Trump said, with this signing, we mark more than just an agreement. We mark a sea change in international trade. At long last, Americans have a government that puts them first at the negotiating table. A stronger America, of course, doesn't come at the rest of the globe's expense. On the contrary, when the United States is thriving, it makes the world a safer, more stable place. A better and fair trade partnership with China will do much more of the same. Starting today, a new era of harmony, prosperity, and commerce officially begins. Representative Jody Ayrton writes in Fox Business, President Trump signed the much-anticipated Phase 1 trade agreement with China after months of hard-fought negotiations. He said, this is a monumental achievement for farmers and ranchers in my district in West Texas and across rural America, who will reap the blessing of China's commitment to purchase as much as $50 billion worth of U.S. agricultural products. This is nearly 100% more than the largest amount of U.S. commodity purchased by China since normalizing relations in the 1970s. How did it happen? For decades, as a result of political short-sightedness and economic expectancy, policymakers have acquiesced to communist-controlled China. At this critical juncture in history, we're fortunate to have a negotiator-in-chief who understands that China is the biggest existential threat to America, and more importantly, who has the political courage to do something about it. The Washington Examiner is reporting that former President Barack Obama's national security advisor fully supported President Trump's decision to kill Soleimani. General James Jones said, what the administration did in the Soleimani case is absolutely correct. He called it a powerful step. According to an article from White House 1600 Daily, New York Times admits President Trump's maximum pressure on Iran is working. Iran's grim economy limits its willingness to confront the U.S. Its headline reads, Iran's is caught in a wrench economy crisis. Jobs are scarce. Prices for food and other necessities are skyrocketing. The economy is rapidly shrinking. Iranians are increasingly disgusted, fearful of public anger over a plunging economy. Iran's leader appeared to be turning inward, pulling back from escalation. And that's this week's Real Trump News. We will see you next time.